Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part six of solving nonlinear systems of equations. We're going to solve this system. We're looking for real numbers only. So basically, that means we're looking for the points of intersection of these two graphs. Now, if you analyze both of these graphs, this first one ends up being an ellipse because we have an x squared and a y squared term with a plus sign, and we have different coefficients. So this happens to be an ellipse, and it's not that easy to graph this ellipse super accurately, but it's possible. And this ends up being a hyperbola, and it's a vertical hyperbola. Because the y squared is positive, and we have that minus something with x squared. So you could also graphically do these, but because of the numbers involved, it's not super simple to graph these these two equations. But if you had a graphing calculator and you did it, it'd probably be easier to see where the solutions are going to be. So instead, we're going to use either the substitution method or the elimination method. The first thing I want you to notice is that if you were going to use the elimination method, which I think I'll do because I haven't done a problem like that yet, is notice I don't have the x squared lined up with the x squared. So I want to rewrite these so they're lined up a little bit better. So on the first equation, I'm just going to keep it as is. But the second equation, I'm going to put the negative 5x squared first plus 7y squared equals 8. Now, if we want to use the elimination method, we could multiply the top equation by 5 so that when we add, our x squared terms will cancel. So that's what I'm going to choose to do because that way you only have to multiply one of the equations by something. So if I multiply this top equation by 5, I have 5x squared. Remember, you have to multiply terms on both sides of the equation by 5. So I have 5x squared plus 10y squared equals, and remember to do the 5 times 12 equals 60. And this second equation, I don't have to multiply by anything. If you want to think of multiplying it by something, you could think, well, you're multiplying by 1, so I have the same equation. So if I add both sides of the equation to get a new equation, my x squared terms add up to 0, so I've got 17y squared equals 68. And then we just divide both sides by 17. And conveniently, we get a whole number, not only a whole number, we have a perfect square. So the arithmetic here isn't bad at all. So y squared is 4, which means y is plus or minus 2. So we've just come up with two values of y. So let's go on to the next page. So here were our original two equations. And once we solve for one of the variables, we need to plug each one in to the one of the equations. It doesn't matter which equation you plug it into to find out what the other variable equals. So I'm going to go ahead and just plug it into the top equation. So I'm going to put in 2 for y into this top equation. And by the way, remember that when I was doing the steps, I got y squared equals 4. So when I plug either one of these in, I'm going to actually just be plugging in 4 for y squared. It doesn't matter whether I put 2 or negative 2 in. You're going to see something parallel going on for both of these values of y. So I'm going to take the top equation, x squared plus 2y squared equals 12, and I'm going to plug in what y squared equals. So keep in mind, y squared for both of these is 4. So that gives me x squared plus 2 times. Doesn't matter if I think of it as 2 squared, I'm still going to get 4 equals 12. So I have x squared plus 8 equals 12. Subtracting 8 from both sides gives me x squared equals 4. So, for that value of when y is 2, x is plus or minus 2. So this gives me two solutions here. 2 for x, y is 2, and negative 2 for x, y is 2. Now, what's going to happen when I plug in y equals negative 2? It's going to look exactly the same because if I take this top equation and plug in negative 2 for y, I'm still going to get this 2 times 4. So you'll end up noticing it looks exactly the same. Even if you don't want to put it in directly, you could first write in negative 2 squared and do your order of operations here. You still get that x squared plus 2 times 4 right there. So we have x squared plus 8 is 12. We know how it's going to go from here. It's going to look exactly the same as it does on the left. But this is when I let y equal negative 2. So my two solutions here, when y is negative 2, right, I got 2 for x, and when y is negative 2, I also got negative 2 for x. So I get four solutions. We could put those together. So it looks like this ellipse and hyperbola intersected in 4 points. Now we always want to check our answers, so we'll go ahead and check our answers, and then if they work, you can go ahead and graph it as well and see, because notice these ordered pairs are kind of easy, so maybe when I graph this it isn't that hard to see what the points of intersection. All right, there's actually four different equations you have to check. You have to check the order pair 2, 2 in each of these equations and also every other one of the ordered pairs. So we have four different ordered pairs. So let's do that quickly. So we have x squared plus 2y squared. In both of these cases, x squared and y squared will be 4. So I'm going to do this quickly. So that's 4 plus 2 times 4. 4 plus 8 is 12. So that checks. And then if we plug in 2 for y, I'll have 7 times 4. Put in 2 for x, 5 times 4. We get 28 minus 20, and that's going to be 8, so that checks. And then you go through and do these for every single one of these. So on the second one, when we put in negative 2, well, the cool thing is negative 2, when you square it, you get the same thing as when you square positive 2. So when you do all of these, they end up looking really similar. We're going to get 4 plus 2 times 4 again. We're going to get 7 times 4 minus 5 times 4 again. So we will get the same answer over and over, and all of these are going to check. So I'm not going to take my time writing all those, but you can certainly plug in the values and check for yourself that these really are the solutions to, here we go. These are the four solutions to this problem. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.